I have some cucumbers, some okra, some squash, some greens, some herbs, strawberries, watermelon, and broccoli. And we're gonna plant these with the sage. Or not with the sage, but right next to the sage. Yes. Right now we're just gonna till the dirt, make sure it's good and mixed up. I had some weeds that grew in there, so I wanna get rid of all of those weed roots. And I grabbed some rabbit poo that I ordered. My mom was an avid gardener, and she said that that's what she used, so that's what I'm gonna use. So I'm gonna do all the greens in this particular, and I'm learning, so I don't know the best way to get these out of here. And I'm just gonna spray the roots a little bit, make sure they're good and moisturized. Want that on a string. And then we are going to plant them. Careful with those leaves. Try not to be so rough with stuff. But we want that to be all the way in there and the dirt to meet the top. Right? Gotta get your hands dirty. Can't be worried about nails and stuff in the garden. I mean, you want to be cute, but you want to be comfortable too, enough to get your hands dirty. So what is that, three? I'll do another one right here. I had some other stuff growing that died, so I'm just gonna plant something else in the same bed. And I already mixed that rabbit poo in with the dirt, so it will give it a lot of good nutrients. I didn't batter the plants. The leaves look terrible. Okay, so what we got? One more. And I'll put that one right here. These are my collard greens. So I'm gonna start on this other side and plant the, I have actually have two more collards. And I'm gonna spray the roots. Just enough to moisturize it, make sure it's going in moisturized, not really dry. And I want that dirt to mix with this dirt, kind of. So just grow together. I'm gonna put all that in my compost. So we got one more collard and then two turnip. So some of them look kind of beat up, but we got the power to bring them. Keep it alive. Necessarily bring it back to life, but okay. Sometimes those roots get to growing. It's been ready to come out, and I'm gonna plant the roots with it, help it grow even more. Pick off the yellow ones. That can go in our compost. So we got all the collards. Now we're going to plant the turnips. Oh, that's good and moisturized. Do that with turnips in this corner. Since these are a little bigger, I'm going a little bit further down to the dirt. Look, I have a tool right here, but nothing like doing it with your hands. And one with the land. Okay. Last one. With the turnips. Everything is planted green-wise. I still gotta do the vegetables and the fruit. This is the greens. And I think we've done a good job. Make sure they pack, got dirt and nutrients packed around them. I'm gonna add a little more dirt to the top. But I like it, I like it, I like it. So, just to make sure they're good, I'm going to spray them. I don't like the way this is strong spraying. Can we get a stream? Get that root really good and wet. And I think these are good. Good and moisturized. So now we have to plant the rest of these. And I have these three bins that I use for potatoes. I think I'm gonna save those for potatoes and use these. So I'm gonna grab some dirt and I'll be right back. Thanks for joining. So I'm going to plant the herbs in this grow bed where I have sage already growing. I'm just gonna plant them way over here in this corner because sage is a beast. But I love it because sage grows winter, summer, spring. It does not matter what time of year it is. The sage is gonna grow. So I have so much now, let's start making sage sticks. I have to pick all those weeds out and leaves as much as I can. Never gonna get them all, but because we're putting that in the compost, we don't care about the dirt either. Look at that. Okay, so we are gonna do some basil right here in the corner. Then I'm gonna do some oregano in this corner and some mint over here. And I just got one because I realized how fast they grow and how much they grow, and I don't really need, well, right now I don't need a ton, but when I start to barter, it's gonna benefit me to have the most. Here we go, basil. Oh, you know what? And I forgot to add some rat poo. Rabbit poo, I mean. Oh my gosh. Definitely don't want no rat poo. And we're just gonna add that to the dirt because it's gonna be amazing for nutrients for the plants. A little bit goes a long way, most definitely. I think that's the sage root. I don't want to pick that. Okay. So we got the basil planted. Let's do oregano. Go deep because it's so much bigger than the small ones. And you definitely keep that label, because that's the hardest thing is once you get to growing stuff, is not knowing what you're growing. So I got that, and we'll do mint. I heard mint is really strong. And it can take over your plants. That's why I only got one. I'm wondering if I should plant this by itself. But I think since I only got one, it will be good. If this starts to spread, then I'll just move it. If it starts to spread too much. Ooh, that smells so good. So we're gonna spray these a little bit. Make sure to do that and moisturize. There we go. That's what I wanted. I wanted to mist the plants. Just a mist, not a strong, strong spray. I cannot find a big water bottle for anything, so I bought this little bitty one. I did not feel like walking all the way around Walmart, but I should have took the stroll. Because it's like 84 in Texas today. I'm going to make sure they're good and moisturized. Okay. That looks good. I'm going to let them settle in their new home. Now we are going to, I have broccoli, green peppers, okra, cucumbers, squash, and watermelon left. So, I'm trying to decide, do I have room to do peppers in the middle? I think what I read said to keep them at least a certain amount of inches apart from each other. So what we'll do is grab some dirt. Out of these empty bins. So, I can do broccoli in one, and then I'm going to do my watermelons in. Actually, I need to do the watermelons in one of those. Since they get big. So let's do the peppers in one. And rabbit poo. And mix that up. I'm gonna add some water. The soil is very dry. Turn it while you're mixing it. Feels like it's saving you some time and some energy somehow. So, these are hot peppers. You gotta go deep, 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 deep. I got some green bell peppers. some extra dirt. Then we're gonna spray him. So got those planted. Now we're gonna do the broccoli. Make sure that dirt is good and mixed. Best way to do it is with your hands. Broccoli. This was a much easier process for me than trying to start from seeding. That was harder for me, so I just decided to skip that process and go right for the plants that are already growing a little bit. Water them, and then I'm gonna add a little bit more dirt. Just to make sure they're good and covered. Dirt to all of them. Okay. We are looking good. So I am gonna do the watermelons in my potato bin. Got eggshells in there as well. It's a whole bunch of loveliness. rabbit poo. And then we just need to add some water. I should have moisturized that dirt a little bit before I done that, but it'll be okay. It will be okay. Well, that's all of the gardening I have for today. Join me next time and have a good one.
Bugs be gone. And this is made with, smells great, but bugs hate it, so don't hesitate to apply 2 to 5 pounds per 1,000 square feet. Also helps keep squirrels, mice, rats, and possums away. Made with cloves, thyme, corn, and wintergreen oil. And it does smell amazing. Add that to the plants. And we are done for the moment. Now it's time to watch them grow. Yay!